Today, we already started discussing about Galerkin's method, and in Galerkin's method, we had a discussion on how to develop a simple equation for any kind of a means. It is simply solving a differential equation using an approximate method. So that we learned it. Also, we covered Galerkin's method for it. And also we were discussing about collocation method and least square method. Along with that, today we are going to also cover an Rayleigh-Ritz method also in this. And these all methods are typically used for solving differential equation. Solving differential equation. This differential equation may be anything. It should not be only kind of only structural analysis kind of an equation should be there or something, but it can be any kind of an even you can solve it by the chemistry equations or any other multi-physics equations. Each and everything we can solve it, but the limitation for this type of an equations or so this method is it can take up in a way it doesn't take on a much more complexity during simulation. It can only take on a few kind of on a more complexity, and it can fit the curve. It is kind of on a fitting the curve to the particular thing under certain condition. Like the condition is that one is boundary condition, another is your differential equation. So we have already seen in this is what on a weighted residual statement. So this is a domain omega, and that domain may be in a 0 to L, 0 to L by 2, depends on how we are going to deal it. This is weight function. This weight function is typically used for fitting or multiplying within your domain residual. And this is what the domain residual. And this is entirely integral we are doing over the domain. That domain may not be for only 1D or 2D, 1D only. It may be in a 2D. If you are going for in a 2D domain, you have to go for in a two times integration. If you are going for 3D, then it becomes in a 3D, 3 times integration. And if you are going to solve 3D plus some dynamic problem, which involves time as in one of the independent parameter, so then it becomes in a 4 time integration kind of things. So in this case, we can now select in a multiple weight function. Means what is actually you are starting with in a simple function, y is equal to c0 plus c1x. This is what in a polynomial I told. But actually, this polynomial is a simple polynomial, and there is one more type of polynomials are already exist into literature. That is what on a Lagrange type polynomials. In that Lagrange also, we are considering some constants, and ultimately you're going to solve it. So when you're going to solve this, means ultimately you need to know the C0 value, C1 value, C2 value. So these values are determined using boundary conditions. One is thing. Another one, it is also used to get the values of these constants using the differential equations. These are the two combinations typically used for getting these two values. And to determine these values, what is to be done? You need to first of all satisfy boundary conditions, then satisfy differential equations, and go on determining C0, C1, C2 kind of things. So that we have seen it last time. So similar fashion, we can now fit any kind of a function. It is only I told here it is a second order. Similarly, I can go for any nth order polynomial. I can use it to get the solution of this differential equation under this boundary conditions. So when we are going to solve this, solution is obtained by integrating. Integral is mostly it is used for minimization purpose. Minimization means we are going to fit the curve, and we are determining minimum potential of it. That is what we are doing. In this case, we are using an Nj. Nj is nothing but your weight function. This is typically in most of the literature you can find in the FEM. So this is what a shape function also called. This is also called as a shape function because whenever we are going to solve any problem, it is going to create a shape of it. That's the reason it is called shape function. And this is what in a domain residual means. You are bringing all the terms of differential equation on one side, and you're going to solve it. You're getting it. Yes, Kedar, I am going to record the sessions. Don't worry about it. If you have any internet issues, I am going to record and I am going to share those on YouTube. Yeah, and daily I am going to update. Whenever we are going to conduct the lecture, we are going to update it by evening, that recorded session. And ultimately, you need to get this, as we need to determine three constants. We need to have three different equations. So, similar fashion, we are going to get the multiple equations, solve it by simultaneously and get these constants. So, when we are going to solve this, we will take a simple example, and that is what a weighted residual. And here also, we are going to use a Galerkin's method. In Galerkin's method, basically, what is going to happen? You are going to start with an even W, R, dx. W is my weight function, R is my domain residual, and dx is my integral domain kind of things. So, here this W should be such that it is whichever the function we are using as an assumed function, we are using as a W, and then it is called as a Galerkin's method. But Galerkin method gives a better result than any other method. That's the reason most of the people follow this Galerkin's approach. So, we will now take a simple example. This is what on a wall, and here it is in a temperature at atmospheric temperature is T infinity, and here it is H is nothing but my heat transfer coefficient. This is the length of the fin, and we want to now determine what will be the temperature at all these middle points from this point to this point. Means my domain becomes here, it becomes an X 0, here X is equal to 0, and here it is an X equal to L. So, I want a solution between this X 0 to X L. So, what the solution I want? I want to determine what will be the value of T when I am going to vary the X. That X is starting with a 0 to L. That is what we are looking for it. So, what are the behavior of this particular part is represented by this differential equation, that is second order differential equation. It is typically ODE also called. ODE means ordinary differential equation. Ordinary differential equation means it depends on only one single parameter, single independent parameter, that is X. That's the reason it is also called as an ordinary differential equation. So here you can find here differential equation K, so second derivative of the temperature with respect to X equal to P is nothing but the perimeter of this entire wall. H is nothing but the heat transfer coefficient. A is area of it. So, this whole parameters are represented here. T is my temperature at in between it, and T minus T infinity is nothing but an atmospheric temperature. This is what on a domain. This is what on a differential equation. This differential equation should satisfy at each and every point on the X to 0 to L. That is what it is expected. So, under what condition it should satisfy? My temperature at base of it, because this fin may be mounted at the engine cylinder. So, we want to now determine what will be the temperature at the base of it. This is what on temperature. This temperature may have been a 500 degrees Celsius or 600 degrees Celsius, whichever you can take it and you can do it. So, this temperature is considered to be in a 300 degrees Celsius. That is what on a first condition. This is a 300 degree current temperature. Another one, at this end, this phase is completely insulated. Insulated means it is not going to allow any kind of a heat transfer. Allow heat transfer means it is that heat is going to transfer as there is a large temperature difference. If the temperature difference is 0, my heat transfer is 0. So, that's what. So, change in the temperature with respect to X, that is what is also called as a temperature gradient with respect to X, is considered to be a 0 as this end is an insulated. Most of the time you may be facing this problem, why this dt by dx. So, this dt by dx represents temperature change. Means if I take a temperature here, maybe in a 200 degree Celsius, and out of this, if I take on a some distance here, so here also I will get on a temperature 200. So difference of these two is always should be zero, and that is what it is got as a temperature gradient, and that is what the property of all insulated tips. So for that purpose, we can consider the K value, that is K is considered to be a conduction constant. And here it is in m square degree Celsius, it should be in a difference of 20, it's not in a 20. K is in a 200, H value is a 20, temperature, that is the atmospheric temperature, is maybe 30 degree Celsius. And ultimately, what is to be done? We need to determine temperature distribution, means ultimately we want to plot on a graph T versus X. X is here my 0 and here it is X equal to L. During this particular zone, what is my temperature variation? Here it is, you have started, this temperature you know it, that is 300. Here the temperature may be anywhere, so that also, but the condition is that it should follow a simple rule, that is what on a temperature gradient. Temperature gradient should be 0. Means the slope of temperature change at this end should be equal to, that is what in a dT by dx should be 0. So try to understand or get in a physical feel of it, why this is called like this, this is called like this, this is what in a which will take you to the more realistic way, and that is what a function you want, T of x. We want to know the different temperatures at all the values, and this is what in a some function you are going to start with, and that is what you want to determine temperature distribution. So we'll start with in a simple start first point. So first step is assume a trial solution. In this assume a trial solution means I will start with a polynomial. But most of the time you may get in a confusion. Why should I all the time take either second order or something? So you just look at the differential equation. Differential equation order is second order. So to get second orders to solve, I need an at least second order polynomial. That is what an basically requirement. So that's what we start with, basically minimum second order differential equation. I can go for many higher order polynomials, no problem. But minimum I should be starting with a second order polynomial. Okay. Then now apply the boundary conditions. What are the boundary conditions? This boundary condition is at x equal to 0. Here it is on x equal to 0, temperature is 300. At x equal to L, derivative of the temperature with respect to x is 0. So that is what it is, we are going to do it. So as we are going to substitute these boundary conditions into this particular equation, if I substitute this into this equation, now I can write it here, 0 is equal to c0 plus x is 0, then x square is also 0, then c0 becomes 0. This is what in the first constant we got it. For second constant, what is to be done? We need to take in a derivative of it, dt by dx. So dt by dx means c0 is a constant, this becomes 0, then c1 x, I can get an only c1, here 2 c2 x. Then now I can substitute x equal to L here, and this is equal to 0, then I can get 0 plus C1 plus 2 C2 into L, and I will get in a C2 is equal to minus C1 is equal to minus 2 C2 L. So this way I will get in a second constant. Ultimately in this equation, now our equation is what? T is equal to C0 is already we know it, that is what 0, we can substitute this C0 here, C1x, so C1 you can bring it here, then C2x, x square. So now I can get an equation T is equal to C0 is 0, C1 as thus, minus 2C2 L into x plus C2x square. Now I can simplify, I can take this C2 out and I can write it. Then T is equal to, my equation becomes C2 into bracket minus L into X minus plus x square. This is what we got. And I can simply write c2 into x. It's x, I can take it common, x minus l. Now my equation becomes x minus l. So this is what an equation we may be using in Galerkin's for weight function, as in a weight function. This is what a t represents. Means ultimately you need to determine c2 now. So this c2 is to be determined into this. Okay. So now we'll move towards the next step. So in next step, so I will get an same. So here c2, this c2, c0 becomes 300 because c2 that I for by wrongly I told you that t of 0 is 0. That's what c0 becomes 300. Then I can now substitute. I will get this equation. Now this equation is further need to be here. We have solved this equations two constant. One is c0 and another was in a c1. And now ultimately what is to be done? One more thing we need to satisfy, that is differential equation. That's what we need to compute residual. Residual means this is what in a differential equation we got. This differential equation, I need to bring all the terms to the one end of it so that I will get an equal to 0 here. That is what it is called as a residual. Now I can bring this pH by AC T minus T infinity to the right side. I'll get this particular part is called as a residual. Now this D2 second derivative we know it. So when I'm going to take on a second derivative, what it happens? T is equal to, that is dt by dx becomes c1 plus c2x square, that is a c2x. Then again one more derivative, that d2 by dx square will result, this x will vanish and only I will get on a 2c2, that is what. So now I can substitute second derivative 2c2 here multiplied with an k, okay, minus 400. And 270 plus this all we can substitute, that is pH T minus T infinity. You can go on substituting. This becomes in a domain residual. This is completely one card as in a domain residual. Now with this domain residual, we need to minimize it. Minimize means ultimately you are going to do it. This domain residual should be multiplied with your weight function and integrated over the domain. Here within the domain there is no variation, which we seen it in previous example, beam example. So because on beam example, moment is going to change at L by 2 distance. Here that kind of a thing is not going to happen. Here we have only one single integral. In previous case we have seen two integral. One is 0 to L by 2 and L by 2 to L. Here we can now substitute wx rd and go on integrating it. Now how to select this wx? Wx, I can now select the wx by considering a simple case. Here you just look at this equation. This is what an equation this is. So here I can have two equations here, x minus 2l something. So this way I can get one equation here. And that I can consider as a weight function. That is what on a two equations, that is x square minus 2lx. So this I can assume as a weight function. Once I get the weight function, we know this domain residual. Now I can take this, substitute this and I can solve it. Now I can solve it into this and I can get this. And once I get all these parameters, what is to be done? I need to solve it for c2. What will be all the values we need to substitute? We got c2. Ultimately, previously we got c0 as in a 300, c1 as in a minus 2c2l. And ultimately, you can now substitute into this c0, c1, c2. And this is what in one single equation we got. And that will tell you the variation of the temperature with respect to x. So that is what it is going to happen. So we can now verify whether we have, what are the boundary conditions we have it, whether it satisfies those boundary conditions or not. So we'll first of all put this first boundary condition here, this boundary condition. When I'm going to substitute x equal to 0 here, so this becomes 0, this will become 0, this will become 0. and this term entirely becomes zero and my temperature becomes 300. Means this is what in the first thing we verified it. So next is, if you take a derivative of this, this will come to be a zero because x minus x ls. This is what, as we are going to take a derivative of it, here it becomes a 2x minus 2l. As I am going to put a x equal to l, what is going to happen? This is going to become 0 and this derivative also, this is constant, this becomes 0. And ultimately, this term becomes 0 and that term, as it is becoming 0, my result also derivative of temperature with respect to the displacement or the x becomes 0. So this way we can get a verification whether we have solved perfectly or not, kind of things. So when we are going to solve such problems, this is what in a weighted residual one example I told. Similarly, you can solve. I will share today a few assignments to you so that you can go on solving few more such examples here. So here we can just look at it. So we have started with a quadratic equation. That is, my equation was t is equal to c0 plus c1x plus c2x square. Okay. So this is what my starting equation. This is a quadratic equation because it is having a second order equation. Now I want to solve it for a cubic solution also. I can go on doing the same thing for a higher order polynomials. Cubic solution means I am going to have a c0 plus c1x plus c2x square plus c3x cube. This is what in a cubic equation. Here I need to determine two constants because two boundary conditions will result into two constants. And that's what we need to have two weight functions. W1 should be there and W2. So which will result into two different simultaneous equation. And these two simultaneous equation will tell me c2 and c3 values. So if I am going for one more term, that is higher order term, that is I can say t is equal to c0 plus c1x plus c2x square plus c3x raised to 4 plus c5x raised to c4x raised to 4. So we have now these two constants can be determined by boundary conditions. These 1, 2, 3 constants are there. So for that purpose, what is to be done? We need to now get a W1 as in one integral, W2 as in second integral, and W3 as in a third integral. Three different weight functions we need to get. Here we'll get one equation, here we'll get a second equation, here we'll get a third equation. These three equations should be solved simultaneously. You will get a C2, C3 and C4 values, and we can substitute and we can get the solution. That is what you can go on increasing order of the polynomial. This type of we are not going to directly discuss about FEM, but here it is, you are increasing the polynomial order. That's what it is called as a P-type refinement. We'll discuss this in more detail when we are going to discuss about actual elemental analysis or kind of things. Here we are not doing, we are only taking an integration and solving the differential equation. Polynomial order, as we are going to increase, that is what it is called as in a P-type refinement. So if you look into this, this is what an exact solution. So this exact solution, when you look at the exact solution is more connected, or this error between this column and this column is less compared to this cubic and quadratic. The reason for this is, as I am going to take on a more and more higher order equations, ultimately what you are getting, we are getting on a more and more closer to the exact solution. That is what it happens. And taking more higher order equations means we need to assume on a more number of weight functions, we need to go for a more number of integrations. And that is what basically a problem increases in computations. We need to go for more and more computations. And here, if you are satisfied with these results, or cubic or quadratic, you need not to go for so many number of weight functions or kind of things. So we'll now look at the next method, that is what the point collocation method. In point collocation method, what is happening, as we know, this is my domain, this is x equal to 0 and this is my x equal to n. In this, we need to satisfy boundary condition. Means this is one boundary and this is my another boundary. I can have a boundary condition will be satisfied. First boundary condition here, second boundary condition you are going to satisfy. And another one is your differential equation. Differential equation should satisfy, means if I am going to plot your residual with respect to x. This is my x equal to 0 and here it is x equal to L. And this differential equation means I am going to plot this. This should be 0 each and every point on the x-axis. But in actual practice, this doesn't happen. And that is what you will find in a big gap between your exact solution and your approximate solution. That may vary in this fashion, may vary in this fashion, may be varying in this fashion. So we need to now identify some points where I want an exact solution, or some point I want this RD should be 0. I will now select on this distance. This may be an L by 3 or something. So here I will now purposefully put this RD equal to 0 and get the constants, or get the solution for this. Then in that case, I will get the RD solution like this. So this will be a 0 here and then it will be like this. So this specific point where I am going to bring my domain residual 0, yeah. So that method, that is what it is called, is on a typical point you are going to select it. And that is what process you are doing it, that is what it is called as a point collocation method, okay. This point collocation method, in this point collocation method, what we are doing in this method, residual is equated to 0 at some points within the domain, that is n selected points. Maybe I am going for 2 points, maybe I am going for 3 points, or maybe n number of points I can go for it. And that how many number of points we need to go for it? That is depends on what kind of a polynomial you are in and how many number of unknown coefficients are to be determined. That is what in the C0 constants, coefficients need to be determined. So that is what, based on that, I can now select that much number of constants into this. So like that, I can now have a constant here, R is there, dx by dt is there. As I want this should be 0 at particular point, maybe x equal to L by 2 or something, what is to be done? I need to equate at x equal to L, I need to substitute, and I will now determine C value like this. That's what, for n number of points, I can go for n such values. And this method is also called as in a subdomain collocation method or point collocation, because we are going to select on a typical one single point where your domain residual is becoming a 0, and that point is called as that type of method is called as a point collocation method or subdomain method. In this case, we'll now take one simple example which we started previously. So that is what on a typically a beam, simply supported beam, point that is middle point, at midpoint you are going to apply the force, and we want to determine the same technique, but we are now using another method. Why I am going to take the same example in each and every case? There is a reason. What is the basically difference in the method we want to identify? If I am keeping a problem as in the same each and every method, for an every method, you can quite easily identify what is the basically a difference in this method. So basically, start with a solution. So here it is a differential equation. So basically, differential equation is in a second order. That equation is d2y by dx square, which is equal to minus m by ei. This is what a second order polynomial, say second order differential equation. And this, we are starting with a one parameter solution. One parameter solution means we are only determining only one single parameter into the solution. That's what it is called as a one parameter solution. In this, we are assuming only one constants. Here only single constants we are assuming. That's what it is, one parameter solution. Now I can start with a shape function or n function that is n is equal to x into x minus l, then we need to just look at whether it satisfies the boundary condition. At x equal to 0, my y function value at x equal to 0, my n should be 0, and at x equal to l, my n should be 0. So these are what the displacement boundary conditions. So these two boundary conditions, if I put this x equal to 0 here, this becomes n equal to 0. And if I put x equal to l here, l minus l becomes 0, and this also becomes 0. So that's what this function satisfies both the end conditions. So once it is satisfies the both the end conditions, now we need to ultimately go for solving for determining c value using this differential equation. Last time we seen it, so this differential equation. Now I can write in a domain residual as an RD, which is equal to EI d2y by dx square minus m. And this should be 0 at every point. Every point means from this point to each and every point on the in the domain. That is what it is expected. And this is not going to happen at way. If you go on doing in a programming, I'm going to tell you how to do the programming for this, and how to look at this domain residual, whether it comes to be in a 0 all the times or not. So when we do in a program, we will come to know how to do it, okay, how to what the way that domain residual varies with respect to x. So then now determine m values, that is this is for 0 to l by 2, and this is for l by 2 to, this should be l by 2, this I have wrongly written l by 2 to here, it should be l. X then L, that is what it happens. And then we can assume this is what on a constant we want to determine, this constant we want to determine it. Now you take on a second derivative, first derivative, second derivative will result into 2c. Now put up on a into the residual equation, this is what residual equation. So this becomes in a this much. And we can now have in two parts. One is 0 to L by 2, because moment is P by 2 into x till this point. And from that L by 2 to L, there is a moment changes, because that is a point where we are going to apply the load. And so I can get in such two equations for this. Now, here, only the thing is that we want to now select the point, some point where I can get in a residual. So I will now select the point x is equal to L by 2 as in a single point. Means I am going to make that my domain, this is my x, this is my domain RD, and here that is middle point. I want this point should be 0 all the time. And maybe it is varying, I don't care about it. That is what I am going to look. That is the way. Now I can put the c is equal to, I want to determine c, and I will substitute x is equal to l by 2 here everywhere. Now I can substitute l by 2 and I can get solution for this, that is what c is equal to pl by 8 ei. Now I can substitute into the equation, I will get the final solution like this, that is y of x is equal to this, and I can now substitute into this and I can get a final solution. At L by 2 distance, my maximum deflection, that is that should happen is equal to y p l cube divided by 48 EI, but here I am getting only 32 EI, means I am not getting exact solution for this. So this should be 48, but it is coming only 32. So this gap is, as we have started with only one single point collocation point. So if I take in a multiple point collocations or multiple points, I can quite easily get in a better results. So we'll now look at the two parameter solution. So similarly, I can go start with a two parameter solution. So same we are going to do it. Only the thing here, we are two parameter means I need to have two constant. One is c1, another is c2. So here I can have on a two functions. One is x into x minus l, another is an x into x minus l square or something. So these both should satisfy our boundary conditions. That is what it is expected. Now I can substitute into my domain residual and I can get the solution for it. So here all the steps are same, nothing is going to change it. Only the thing is that I am going to now select two points into the domain. One is C1, one is for determining C1, another is for C2. Now I can select on a point at L by 2 as a one point. And then L by 2 and another point I will substitute as a 3L by 4. So these are the two points where I am going to make it point collocation, that is domain residual equal to 0. And I will now get on a C1 one equation from this particular equation. Second equation I will get here. And I can now solve these two equations simultaneously. So as I am getting and solving this simultaneous equation, I will get on a two equations, C1 is equal to this and C2 is equal to this. Now I can substitute back into my final equation. So here I will now substitute C1, C2, C2 is 0. So now I will get a solution at x equal to L. What will be the, here it is becoming a 64. So your exact solution was PL cube divided by 48. Here we got 64, somewhat on higher side. So we can now choose some other collocation point. Now we can select some other collocation, maybe it is creating a problem. That's what I can go on doing this for some other points, that is L by 3 and 2L by 3. Now I can go on substituting this. So same way I will get a C1 value, C2 value, and then final equation becomes this. Now I can L by 2. Here it is coming in a somewhere perfect. So here I am getting in a perfect solution, which is exactly matches with this. So here in this point collocation method, which point you are going to select, that matters a lot. How much your results are accurate in, that is depends on how you are going to choose the points, and that is what it is called, isn't it? That is what driving your accuracy of your system, accuracy of your solution. So that is what the way you can have in a point collocation method for one parameter, two parameter. Similar fashion, you can go for n number of parameters also. If you have any question, you can ask now. I'll take in a few minutes for your question answers onto this. Yeah, bol.
Ha. Barobar. हाँ एक्चुअली कसं आहे तू आता बघितलंस इफ यू सी इट एल बाय टू इफ यू सिलेक्ट इट व्हॉट इज गोइंग टू हॅपन आय गॉट अन अ रिझल्ट इन लोअर साइड दॅट इज इट इज एक्सपेक्टेड 48 आय गॉट अन 32 समथिंग ओके सो इफ आय एम गोइंग फॉर अन टू मोर पॉइंट्स लाईक एल बाय थ्री ऑर समथिंग सो आय गॉट 64 समथिंग आता ऍक्च्युली कसं आहे की व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू प्लॉट दिस यूजिंग अन अ काइंड ऑफ अ प्रोग्राम you will come to know ki what is where I am getting a perfect result. Which point means you can initially I can tell you one thing. You need to select these numbers randomly first of all. Once you select the random numbers and based on that you will come to know with an experience where I will get a perfect results. Okay. And if I'm not getting the results at perfect, don't worry about it. Somewhere it matches with an approximate because it follows domain residual. So what we will do, we plot this domain residual with respect to x. Okay. So if you plot this domain residual with respect to x, what it happens, you will come to know where I want in the domain, mean domain to be at 0. Means I'll show you here. So this here, this is my x-axis, this is my RD. I'm selecting this point, these two points. Means here it is in a L by 3, I'm going to select it. And here it is a 2L by 3. 2L by 3. My domain is here again 0 because we are going to apply the boundary conditions. So that domain is going to show me this kind of a variation. If I select only one single point, what is going to happen? It is going to vary in this fashion. That is what a large variation you can find in this case. Here, if I go for some other point, like I took it L by 2, here in previous case L by 2 I took it, and another point which I think 3L by 2 something, okay, 3L by 4 means I am going to concentrate on right side of my domain. Here the one point I am going to concentrate this during this point means I am going to put this domain maybe variable session. So during this phase it is concentrated more. Here it is a less concentrated. Obviously, I will get a less or wrong result in this zone. But here I am getting a more better results like this. Wronger, I can say I will get a more gap in this. But here I am getting a less gap. This is what it is going to happen. So that's the reason we need to select an appropriate point. Okay. So how you are going to play with this particular graph and your numbers, where you are going to put it, that matters a lot. If you are going to solve few more examples, you will come to know. Any other questions? I think this will solve your thought. Okay. Okay. So there is one question here. So in PinFin slide, how you choose the weight function? Actually, weight function is to be initially, because that is what a major problem in all FEA, this kind of methods, which polynomial is to be selected. That's what we need to start with, in a simple polynomial, that is C0 plus C1x plus C2x square. So we'll solve solve boundary conditions, okay? And then you will come to know that is it is going to have a 300 plus x into x minus l, okay, and into my constant. This x minus x into x minus l. So this is what in a function which is typically repetitive in your function, even in your assumed function. So that's the reason it is selected from this end as a weight function. Understand? Any other question? So this is going to repeat. You can find this into your solution. Okay, I will go back to slides so that. Okay, so here it is selected this weight function. Here weight function you want to select it. So this weight function x square minus 2lx is selected from this point, from this part. And that's what it is called as a Perkins method. This was picked up from your main assumed function. And it should satisfy the boundary condition. I think this is what in a clear understanding. Is that clear, Avadhut? Haan, tithunach karayche. Karan kasa hota? Baryach vela je assumed functions ahet. Karan ha jala basic part. Hyachyanantar apan weak formulation madhe janar. Tyavele suddha aplyala ashech functions tya particular boundary condition satisfy zalyanantar je function tayar hoil. Tyachyatunach to function pick up karayche. Apan jasta शोधत बसायचं नाही की हे फंक्शन कसं आलं ते फंक्शन कसं आलं त्यापेक्षा पिकअप द फंक्शन फ्रॉम दिस आणि बेसिकली कंडिशन काय कारण दिस इज गोइंग टू सॉल्व युअर बाउंड्री कंडिशन्स ओके इट इज इट सॅटिस्फाईज युअर बाउंड्री कंडिशन दॅट्स व्हॉट दिस फंक्शन अँड वेट फंक्शन ऑल्सो शुड सॅटिस्फाय बाउंड्री कंडिशन देन अँड देन दिस विल गेट मॅप इट अदरवाइज इट विल नॉट मॅप इट अँड दॅट्स व्हॉट दिस फंक्शन शुड बी सच दॅट इट शुड सॅटिस्फाय युअर बाउंड्री कंडिशन्स. Okay, so if it is going to satisfy your boundary conditions, then you can take any kind of a function. I can now select a sine of x or something also, but it should satisfy these two boundary conditions anywhere. Kya ja duni cha duni boundary conditions hai, kya satisfy ya particular function jar karat asel, so that also you can use as a weight function. Is that clear? Yeah. So we'll now move towards on the next part. I think this is what on a understanding from point collocation method. He lakshat ala ka saglyancha kai doubts astin tar vicharun gya
कारण आपलं कसं आहे की डायरेक्ट जर एकमेकासमोर बसलेलं असेल तर इझी टू अंडरस्टँड, बट इट इज ऑनलाइन मोड बिकम्स टू मच अंडर दिफिकल्ट टू हँडल दिस इश्यूज. ओके, so we'll now look at least square method. In least square method means, I will now first of all, before going for a least square method, I'll just take one simple case. I want to fit the curve. There are x point and there is a y point. I have these points. This is one point, second point, third point, fourth point, fifth point. So we want in some curve or straight line which passes through, which is having a minimum distance of this. This is what a minimum distance I want from my line. And this is nothing but an equation of my line is C0 plus C1x. So ultimately you want to determine C0 and C1. That is what it is expected. So now I have an x1. Here it is a one point as x1, y1. Here it is an x2, y2. So similar fashion x3, y3 and kind of things. So when we are going to determine this C0, C1 values, ultimately this distance should be minimum. So for that purpose, what we have done, we have taken some of errors. Error means I have a y values, then my model values. This is nothing but my error. So this is what model means, that is what this equation and actual values are this. So this error should be zero for my case. Under what condition it will become zero? If I take a C, zero on one axis, C1 on other axis, and third axis I will consider as in yi and minus ym. I need to know the C0, C1 values such that this, what are the 3D graph, you can just look at it. So I can't draw it perfectly, but you can, I think you people can imagine it. So this is the point where I will get a minimum value. That is what I am expecting. So this is what, this is the error. If I take this here, my error is, this is my error is negative. Here it is a negative. Here I get a positive. Here I got a positive and here again negative. So just imagine here this error is in a 2. Here it is again 2. Here positive error is 4. This is minus 2, minus 2, plus 4, 4, minus 2, minus 2. If I am going to sum it, this becomes 0. So information in these numbers, okay, these numbers or these points with respect to this particular line, I, as I am going to sum it, it is going to lapse. I will get a 0. So that's what the reason is, that if I square this, just imagine 4 is a square, 16. 2 minus 2 square, it becomes 4, positive 4. Minus 2 square again, it'll become 4. So this is what the reason is, that remove this positive or negative part. So convert into one, only one side. That's the reason we need to square it. So that's what we squared it. So once I square it, so ultimately you want to determine C0 and C1. So for that purpose, what I will do, ultimately sum of yi minus ym, and I'm going to square it. Why I'm going to square? Taken positive as well as negative differences into account. That's the basically we want to take it. That's the reason we need to square it. And this is what in a sum you are doing to do, going to do it. And ultimately you want a C0 values here on C1 values, and here it is in my error. That is what y minus ym. This error should be zero or minimum at particular point. And I want this point should be such that my particular graph, or I'll get, if I'm going to substitute these values, so I'll get this particular point as an optimum point. So if I plot in 2D, just look at it here. So on C0, for I will consider only one single parameter, yi minus ym. I am going to, this is something like this. This is the minimum point of error with respect to C0. As I am going to change the C0 with, as this error is going to change it. And at this point only I will get in the max, minimum error. So that's what I can have in a two equation. Daba by daba C0 is one equation. And another equation is daba sum of yi minus ym square daba C1, same fashion, I should be equal to 0. So here I will get one equation from this. Okay, because it is a slope, it is representing slope. This is one equation, this is my second equation. I can solve it simultaneously. I will get C0 and C1 from these two equations, and I can now substitute into y is equal to C0 plus C1x. So that is what in a method we have seen is called as a least square method. Least square error. This is what an error. You are squaring it, you are minimizing it by taking a derivative. That is what a maxima minima principle. We learned it. And that's the reason this is what a technique is called as a least square. Same kind of an approach is taken into account when we are going to solve it here also. That is what a least square method. I think this is what you cleared your doubts and reviewed our previous stuff. So in this case, I have an integral here. That integral is nothing but an 0 to L W into R dx something. In this integral, I have only C constant values, maybe in the C0, rega, C1, C2, these constants. So C0, C1, C2 should be such that this integral should be 0 all the time. When it will be 0? So when I am taking a derivative of an integral with C0 and equating to 0, that indicates I here and on axis C0. So this is what an occur. I am getting somewhere minimum at this point or equal to 0 sometimes. This curve may be something like this. So here the slope of my curve becomes 0. That's what I am going to do it. And that is what we done at here, di with respect to ci. That is what derivative of integral with respect to constant we are doing it. And that is what it is called in the least square method. And this I is integral. And here I am going to now change the C with respect to time. This method will result into n number of algebraic equations. I have a three constant, just imagine. I have three constants. I want to determine three constants. What I will do? I will go on integrating three times. And I will get three equations and I can solve it. We will take a simple example for this. One parameter solution, same numerical we will take. And this is what a beam bending equation, and same we have discussed it previously. Deflection of the beam is assumed to be a one parameter solution, means I am going to look at only one single constant I want to determine it. That is what C. Now I can substitute into boundary conditions, load deflection curve. Now where this two moments same as in a previous case, and then taking this as another, now substitute into your residual, and from this point your method changes. From this point onward your method changes. You are going to substitute into this. So now your equation is two phase, one is 0 to L by 2 and another is L by 2 to L. So here at I got the constants. Now I can substitute this into this, take a derivative of it. Equate this derivative equal to 0. Once I equate with respect to 0, only unknown is C. I can get the C value as a PL by EI. And that is what I can now, I can substitute into my final equation, and L by 2 I will get this is what the solution. That is 32 I will get. Ultimately we want 48. Here also we will get a big difference. Okay. So that is, we can similarly solve it for 2-point parameter solution or kind of things. And we can get a better solution here. Okay. Is there any doubt into this?
Yes, Avadhoot, do you have any question? Pranali? Yeah. No. I think we need to stop. Already we have taken 1 hour part of it. And I will stop it here. So I will now take an